I'm Stephen Hardy, Editorial Director of LightWave. Companies across the optical communication spectrum are having to deal with the impact of the COVID-19 coronavirus and its effect on bandwidth demands. To get some insight into this issue, I'm speaking with Ankit Agarwal, CEO Connectivity Solutions at STL. Ankit, the coronavirus outbreak has disrupted the operations of almost all companies globally. What has been the impact on STL, and how are you addressing these challenges?
Yes, Stephen, absolutely. It's been, since day one of, implications of COVID restrictions by the government, especially in India, our first response was to ensure the safety of employees. And we made sure that we acted absolutely quickly in a very agile way. We ensured that our employees are following the norms of the government for work from home. We enabled all the video conferencing and other interactive tools to ensure that they were agile, at the same time able to meet the requirements of their work. At the same time, we reached out to our customers and our partners to make sure that they were updated from time to time, so that there were no surprises in terms of where we stood in terms of our commitments towards them. After this, over the last 3 to 4 weeks, we have also seen the situation improving. We are now allowed to operate at about 30% of our workforce. And so we're slowly bringing our factories up to speed in India and absolutely following all the safety norms, all the social distancing norms that have been recommended by the government. In addition, our operations in China are also coming on stream, and we're ensuring that we can use these facilities to cater to our customers. Italy and Brazil as well are running at stream now, and we look forward to serving our customers from all these operations. In addition to this, I'm very proud to share that our chairman, Mr. Anil Agarwal, has committed close to $30 million to fight the COVID virus and support the Indian government in terms of any requirements, whether it is PPE kits, whether it is masks, isolation beds. All of these are being supported by our chairman. In addition to that, as Sterlight, we have taken on a task of training over 100,000 people in India on safety measures related to COVID virus.
So while STL has been taking the necessary steps to deal with the impact of the coronavirus, both within the company and within the general community, your network operator customers are facing challenges of their own. That includes a rapid increase in data demands within their networks. Do you see this as a sustainable trend, and what impact will this have on your business going forward?
Yes, absolutely, Stephen. I think there's a fundamental shift in the way the networks both are getting consumed and also uploaded. So there has been a huge shift in the way the amount of data, especially that has been going upstream, where the operators are also having to very rapidly invest in the networks. We're seeing this not only in India with the large telecom operators, but equally in developed countries, in Europe, in UK, equally in North America. So clearly, this is a global phenomenon. The amount of data consumption in the operator network is probably expanded by at least 50 to 70% across networks. And this is probably going to keep on increasing as people just get more and more used to working from home or working in a distributed manner. In addition to this, with some of the new applications which are increasing in use, like gaming, like AR, VR, as people are working from home, and more and more automation is coming in, we're clearly seeing that latency becomes increasingly important. And in this scenario, you need to develop more and more edge networks. As a result, we believe that not only will you need more large data centers, you will also need to build more edge data centers to make sure that you can cater for this latency requirement. At STL, we're clearly seeing that the operators are looking to invest significantly more in their fiber network, but equally build the edge network out. In addition to this, we also believe that the governments will start to step in and start making significant investments to improve the quality of broadband in their country, to enable people to work from home and to keep the industries moving forward.
So how well positioned is STL to take advantage of the demand growth we expect to see over the next 12 to 18 months?
Yes, Stephen, we're absolutely excited, and we're looking forward to how we address this growth that we see in our markets globally. We believe that we have done a tremendous amount of work in building a strong R&D portfolio. We have close to 350 patents now, which we have developed through the years, working very closely with our customers and our partners. As a result of this investment in R&D and innovation and building up our team, we are working in a very, very agile manner with our customers to solve some of their biggest network challenges. In addition to this, we have also expanded our portfolio to look at IDS, which is a data center design company. We believe that that will bring tremendous capability to us as a company. And we have now taken a small investment into ASOX, which will also help us build a virtual radio access network capability. So we are very excited with the way the world is evolving towards 5G, towards larger fiber to the X penetration. And we believe we have a very important role to play in that.
So we've seen several innovations from STL over the last few years, including two products that we recently recognized as part of the 2020 LightWave Innovation Reviews. What other new products can we look forward to in the near future?
Yes, Stephen, we're very proud of the two innovations that you mentioned. The first one is Stellar Fiber, which is really first of its kind in the world. We're very proud of our Stellar Fiber, and we're seeing very strong interest from telecom operators around the world. In addition, the second solution was really custom built for the data center interconnect. And that, again, is getting strong interest in terms of our True Ribbon cable solution. Those are great examples of what Sterlite stands for the innovation that we bring to the table. And I believe that on all the areas of the network, really starting from the trunk going into all the way to the access, we believe that all the elements of the network, you will see tremendous innovation from Sterlite in the time to come. We're seeing that telecom operators and cloud companies are investing significantly in ramping up their fiber networks, whether it's for 5G, whether it's for fiber to the home, for small cell application, or just for bringing the latency down. And for all of this, we're looking at all kinds of solutions to increase the speed of deployment, to reduce the cost of deployment, and at the same time, significantly reduce the loss during transmission. I believe that in the time to come, Sterlite will be a world leader in this space, and we look forward to the feedback from our customers and our partners around our innovation.
Thank you, Ankit. Communications infrastructure has proven to be a key element as the world navigates the coronavirus pandemic. And as you've just heard, the optical communications community is rallying to ensure that fiber networks continue to support increases in bandwidth demand. For LightWave, I'm Stephen Hardy.